Hi, Alex here from Rebelloper.com and welcome back to our Christmas calendar tutorial series. And today it is St. Nicholas Day, and for those of you who are still coding today, I want to give you a present. And for those of you who are not coding today, here is my present. Okay, in this tutorial, we will learn how you can create a custom Xcode file template. So let's dive in. Great. Now, what are exactly file templates? Let me just open up one of our projects, and I will use this test new template. And inside the file, you can see file new, and you can select file. Okay, here are the Xcode Apple provided basic templates, and you can choose a Swift file, a Cocoa Touch class, but I want to show you how you can create your very own custom files, file templates within Xcode. And we are going to create this awesome Rebelloper class file template. So let's jump right into it and see what it actually does. I will select this and click on next. And here you can see that I have two chances. UI view and UI view controller. I don't really know why all of the others appeared, but hey, let us just select first of all our view controller. And as you can see, our view controller default ending has added there. And I will just type in here test. I will choose the language of Swift and let's click on next. The place is okay, so let's create that. So, as you can see, this differs a little bit from the basic UI view controller class that is created from an Xcode template. And it differs in the simple file private function setup views, and it is added in the view did load. Now, the same is added to our UI view. I am just adding a setup view as a file private function. Now, let's take a look at how do we actually create these templates. Okay, so let me just maybe minimize this and go ahead and download the resources by clicking the link down below, and you will be presented with these templates folder and the templates paths. Now, let us first of all open our templates paths text edit, and here you can see that I have two paths. One is for the default templates that come with Xcode, and the other one is for your very own custom templates, because we don't want to add our templates into the app of in the Xcode app. As you can see, we are inside our Xcode app, because let's say you delete the Xcode or just simply update it, and those files could be erased. So it's a good place to add it here under library, developer, Xcode, and templates. So first of all, let's take a look at what we got in the Xcode app. So let me just open up a new finder here, and let's select go and go to folder and copy and paste the path. So let's go there. And as you can see here, we have some file templates. Apple Watch, Playground, Resource, Source, and User Interface. Let's take a look at Source and Cocoa Touch. And here you have your UI Collection, View Controller, Table, Swift, and so on. And what I have tweaked is this UI View Controller Swift and our UI View Swift. And if you just go there, let me just go to our view controller. You can see it has a file base name .swift, and that is what we need to provide. Let me open that up. And here you can see the basic template for a UI view controller. It has a file based name as identifier, variable CocoaTouch subclass, our view did load, and some comments for our view did load and the navigation. So let's close that off and go ahead and maybe copy it out to your liking and modify it. Now, one important part here is besides the cool icons, so the template icons, here we go, is this template info.plist file. Now, this is where we set up our template, and I will jump right into it in my own modified version. Go ahead and take a look at it here if you want to. Now, once you create all of your view controllers or whatever and add them into your template info plist file, go ahead and add them to this path, to your templates. Let me open up a new Finder window here, and again go to folder, paste that in there, and go and select your template files. If these folders aren't there, maybe the templates isn't there, or maybe the file templates isn't there, go ahead and create them. So it's Rebeloper and Rebeloper class. And if you remember, the Rebeloper and Rebeloper class, they are in the UI of Xcode. Rebeloper, this one, is the group name, and Rebeloper class is the actual template's name. Let me just show you once again what I mean. So file, a new file, and let's just scroll down. Here we go. Rebeloper is the group name, Rebeloper class is the actual template's name. Okay, so let's cancel that and let's go back. Here we have our icons and our UI view controller for Objective-C. And let's just dive into our UI view controller Swift. Just take a look at the UI view Swift for yourself. It's basically the same. So let me just open that up. And as you can see, it is pretty straightforward. We import UIKit. Here we have our file header and file based name as identifier, a variable CocoaTouch subclass. And here we have our setup views. Okay, pretty straightforward. Okay, now let's take a look at the most interesting part, our template info.plist file. So let's open that up. Let me make this a little bit larger. It is a small on my screen, and unfortunately I couldn't find a way how to make this a little bit larger, but go ahead and open it up on your computer and follow along. Okay, so for the description, we have our Rebeloper class, summary Rebeloper class, and sort order is one. Okay, if you have more than one, go ahead and add the sorting order of two and so on. Default completion name is my class if you don't want to add any names there, and but hopefully you do want to add platforms. Of course, COM, Apple, Platform, iPhone, OS, so leave that alone. And under options, let's take a look at these items. So for the first item, well, item 0, we need to have the name of the class to create. And this is the description, and the name is appearing for before the text that we actually want to implement in there. So required, so it is required. If you set this to no, then it will not be required. And make sure that the identifier is product name or something that you remember that you can use later down the road, and I will show you where. It is of type text, and not persistent is persisted is set to yes. This actually means if you type in something and a file name, and then you create that file name and you want to create another file name, the name isn't popped into that field as the last name. So yes is the way to go in our case. So let's take a look at item 1. what class to subclass in the new file, subclass of, and here we have our UI view, and we need to import UI kit. Don't really mess with this, because this is for our UI view. Let us just go down and take a look at the XIB file. We are not going to use XIB, so I won't cover that. Rather yet, let's take a look at the yes, here we have our implementation language. Default is Swift. We have some values, Swift Objective C, and main template files. Swift is, this is basically the name of the file that will be created, and this file base name will be used from this product name, so make sure that you add that right. And allowed types, Swift, let's take a look at that. Swift source, don't bother with that. Let's jump back to item one, and into values we have our UI view and UI view controller, and I believe for suffixes, yes, we have for the UI view controller, we have this view controller suffix added automatically, as you saw it in the example. So if you want to create new, let's say, views or view controllers and so on, go ahead and add it into these values. Let me just show you once again. We have this UI view controller and UI view. Now, that is it for creating our template files for Xcode. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And I dare you again and again and again to hit that notification bell to get notified when new videos come out. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.